The ayes. Mr. Alistair, point of order.
Mr. Speaker, you're going to invite us just in a moment to consider another motion. And the House is being invited to consider that motion without debate. And yet that motion will remove from the facility of members the opportunity during coming weeks to ask oral questions of ministers in this House. That seems to me to be a wholly retrograde step, compounded by the fact that we're not even to debate it. Now, I recognise entirely that these are utterly unprecedented times, that our focus should be single-minded in respect of the medical crisis. But in this House, we are sent here as MLAs, and part of that function is to scrutinise the work of the executive. Now, the executive tomorrow or in the following days, once the coronavirus bill is passed, will acquire immense draconian powers, because that act is effectively an amazing special powers act. And yet, at the same time, we're going to coincide that with removing from this House the regular facility to question ministers in question time. That's not happening generally elsewhere. It's not happening in Westminster. The First Minister in Scotland is still taking questions, and I believe so in Wales. And yet in this House, we're going on the nod to remove that facility from members. I think that is incongruous. I think it is wrong. And I think it's particularly wrong that we're going to do that without debate. If that's the will of the House, then let it be manifested in debate. But you know, this House is a place apart. It's a place without an opposition. And yet now, we're going to have an executive remove from them the facility of members even questioning them. That seems to me wrong.
I thank the member for giving me advance notice of the point of order that he wishes to raise and which he has just raised. But I would like to think that